my second book is Balancing It All. So it is about my stories of juggling priorities and purpose. And it's written in very autobiographically in that it takes you through my journey in life and all those pivotal moments where decision-making really shaped who I am as a woman and a wife and a mom and how you manage to balance those things. But
why do you think women have such a difficulty with this? In other words, this is such a hot button topic. So that, you know, when I saw your book, I thought, that's it. I mean, what woman today is not asking herself, how do I balance it all? How do I do that?
Yeah.
Why do you think today that is so hard?
Because I think that I think we can look at one another and we aren't satisfied with just being one thing because we see people, we're juggling so much. I mean, there's when we have children or a husband and then want a career and yet some women who choose not to have a career or be a stay-at-home mom or a homeschooling mom, it's like there are things that make us feel like we're not valuable enough or we don't measure up to that woman that is juggling 10 things in her life.
Well, especially with social media, because everyone is on Facebook, they're putting a different face on there or saying something. And you know, you're like, oh, today is amazing. Meanwhile, you wanted to just like strangle your child. Don't do that.
And by the way, speaking of Hollywood and balancing it all, I mean, it needs to be said, a lot of the families in Hollywood, they've got like 12 nannies and, you know, 9 governesses and all kinds of every child has his own gardener, you know. And the thing is, you're in Hollywood, you're successful as an actress, but you're really doing this on your own. You're really actually raising your kids on your own. You don't just have staff that you farm out the kids to.
No.
Right?
I don't have any staff. No. Sometimes I really wish that I did have staff, but I don't have any staff. But you know what? Here's the thing, and I talk about this because I don't feel that I'm any better of a person because I don't have people helping me. I do have people
Even though
people
you are,
helping.
You don't feel that
I
way.
I just haven't paid for help because it's like my parents help me. My husband helps me. My friends help me. We all need help. Like, it really does take a village.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, so, definitely.
We were just saying this. Like, I would not be able to do anything that I'm doing today just without my parents. Like, they'll stay with her and the safety that you know, okay, she's with my parents. I know they're gonna love my child.
You know that your kids aren't gonna get more messed up than you are.
Exactly. Right. That's exactly what I was thinking. Now, I was watching you on TV and there was an interview and this woman, it was like this uproar about the word submissive, right? Mm-hmm. And she was just, I just don't understand. What do you mean by submissive? Why do you think there was such an uproar?
You know, it's funny because we all are submissive people in that we have to submit to authority, government, laws, our bosses. We do submit every day. But I think that
and you can't mention God on this show, by the way.
Okay.
We're also, by the way, supposed to submit to God.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I think that people don't like being told what to do. So that word is offensive right away. But when we look at really the biblical definition of that word, it means to obey meekly. Meek is strength under control. It's bridled strength.
In the original Greek, I'm Greek, so I know that is that's actually true though. People don't know that. Meekness, our view of meekness is very different from it. It means strength. It's like you think of a powerful horse under control. I mean, it's bridled power, totally different from lack of power.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So I talk a little bit about that in the book because I talk about my marriage, but my book is not a marriage book. But my husband and I choose to submit our lives and our marriage to God. But within that, you know, my husband's the leader of our family, and I love that. I love that. You know, he leads us, and I feel that I'm the heart, I'm the love and the nurture in there. And so it's a perfect balance.
It is so countercultural. It's just tremendously countercultural, which all the more reason that I'm thrilled that you wrote this book, because people are just, as I say, people buy into these cultural cliches. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know, it's everybody's got to be empowered or whatever, as if, you know, what you're talking about is not what it's a beautiful thing.
I couldn't be an actress and a producer and an author and have 3 children and a 17-year-long marriage if I were a woman that was subservient and didn't have a voice.
But if you think about it, someone has to lead, right? Like, you can't both be like,
two people can't be sitting driving a car at the same time.
Exactly.
But you can have the navigator telling you where to go,
but even
what to
the
do.
Woman being like, you just said so powerful, which I love, and I always say, I feel like I am the heart Yeah. And my husband is the head. And together, yeah, when we're working, it is, yeah, like unison, works, and it's powerful.
I'm the kidney in our marriage.
You are.
I really wrote this book in through my own journey. And I think it's important for women to realize that none of our lives are gonna look the same. So balance is different for everyone else, and we don't have to compare ourselves to one another.
And shouldn't.
And because if you have three things that are very important in your life, then you invest in those three things really well and not look at the other woman that might be juggling 10 things and think that you have to do the same as the other. I think when women realize that we don't have to compare our lives and ourselves to one another, we will have a big sigh of relief and go, just invest in the things that we're truly, that God has given us to invest in and do that well. But I talk about things that, again, are important to me in my life that help me balance. One of those things are charitable works. I mean, philanthropy is so incredibly important to me and my family, and something that I do along with my children. It's so important that we have fun, mm-hmm, as adults.
Fun, absolutely. Because it's so easy
adults
to like forget about
to have
having fun.
Yeah. I mean, absolutely. Not to the detriment of like your family, but like you need those girls' nights out, even though my husband is incredibly important to me. But sometimes my husband doesn't want to listen to everything.
Exactly.
You know, so it's like that's what our girlfriends are for. And you know, and I talk about even more stuff with children and school and discipline and all kinds of things. But I think it comes down to really, you know, knowing what's valuable and important to you and your family. And looking at those things, I think that will naturally create, when they overlap, it'll create a balance in your life that's right for you.
I have to say, as a man, you know, it's encouraging to me that you seem to just have a very healthy approach to this, kind of a down-to-earth, mm-hmm, you don't look down-to-earth,
very
you look beautiful
earth
in Hollywood, but you have a down-to-earth soul, and that's needed. So thank you for being with us. And
you're
success
welcome.
With this wonderful
me.
Book, Balancing It All.